Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to my channel. If you're new to my channel, hi, I'm Akanksha. It is day, I don't know which day it is, but I hope you're enjoying the Navratri series. And yeah, today's video is going to be a full face of drugstore makeup. I created this look using only drugstore products. If you want to see how I created this look and my recommendations, then yeah, keep on watching. So let's start off with moisturizing our face. Even if you don't know anything or don't do anything, at least before going in with your makeup, do use a moisturizer. It just moisturizes and hydrates your face and the makeup goes on really well. If you have dry patches or anything, your makeup doesn't go on that well. So it's always good to moisturize. And other than that, even like when you add a lot of powder, your skin tends to kind of get dry. So it's always good to add a moisturizer. So I'm going in with the Mamaearth Oil-Free Apple Cider Vinegar Moisturizer. It's my ride or die. I really like it. My skin has been acting up lately, so I went back to that and it never like fails me. Not sponsored, but yeah, I spoke about this in like more than 100 videos till now, I think. But it's a really good moisturizer for any skin type. So I'm just like prepping my skin with that. So if you have like a really good hydrating primer, then you can definitely go in with that as well. But in drugstore, it's kind of a little difficult to get your hands on a very good drugstore like hydrating primer. So I'm just going with my moisturizer so that you also can go. Or else, you know, you can use like primer water, or let's say you can use that Bobbi Brown Vitamin Enriched Face Base. So it's like a very hydrating type of base before you go in with your makeup. So I just went with the same moisturizer under the eye. Like I always tell you, you can use the same moisturizer under the eye. You don't have to use separate eye cream. Now let's go in with primers. Going in with this Lakme Absolute Gel Primer. I like the gel one. The Blur Perfect is not one of my favorite, but I really like this one. So I'm just taking this and applying only right here because that's where I have like that a little big pore. So this will just fill that in and cover it up. Even on my nose a little bit, so that, you know, primer is not something I always wear. I'm just giving you an option that this is a good one if you do want to get your hands on it. But I like personally, I don't know, usually I forget to apply a primer. Now next, you know the drill, I have oily skin, so I'm going to go in with the powder and set my face, basically the T-zone, before going in with the foundation so that oil is under control. No, it doesn't get cakey at all. So usually I go in with that Maybelline Fit Me, but I know you guys are tired, and recently I've been enjoying this K-Beauty powder. This is the shade Olive. It's a tad a bit darker on the foundation, but you know, while bare skin, it's kind of fine. So I'm just going to take my brush. I'm just going to lightly dab it. You can use a sponge or a brush. You will use a sponge if you want to add a lot of it. If you just want to dust it off, then you can go in with the brush. I'm just going to lightly dust it because I'm anyways going to remove this makeup after the video is done, so there's no, like, I don't really need to add a lot of powder. So I don't know if you guys can see, you can see that very, like, only in the area where I added powder, you can see that red, a little more warmer shade. So that's from the powder. That's, I'm the only problem I have is with the shade. And even, you know, with colored powders, that is the problem, that to get the perfect shade of powder is really difficult. Translucent, it's like you can use any like shade of foundation and concealer and it doesn't change because the powder is translucent. But one more thing is that does give a flashback, so you know, you have to adjust somewhere. So next for foundation, I was going to pick the Maybelline Fit Me because nothing beats it, bro. It's one of the most like beautiful foundations in the drugstore period. Really, really good in terms of coverage, stay, etc. But again, I didn't want to like repeat myself. So I'm using the Milani Conceal Plus Perfect. 2-in-1 is a foundation plus concealer. So it kind of gets really good coverage. I really like the finish of this foundation. Really, really beautiful. You can, you know, I would like wear this foundation to any event and it won't fail me. It's such a beautiful foundation. But just that, a little price point for a drugstore foundation, this is a little pricey. I think this is around 1100 or 1200 if I'm not wrong. But you know, like I said, Maybelline is always there, like that's a safe spot to go if you don't have a lot of budget. So I'm just going to take this and I'm actually going to mix a little bit of Maybelline with this because this is like a tad bit darker on my skin. So I'm just like, you know, going to take two pumps of this. I'm going to first like dot it on the face where I actually need a lot of coverage, which is usually just on my cheek because I have a lot of acne marks there. Then I'm going to go in with my Maybelline Fit Me 310, and this is a little bit light on me, so it kind of balances out. I'm going to add three dots of that. I'm going to blend that out, and for that I'm using this sponge from Vice_She. I used to love this sponge, I still love this sponge, but this was like somewhere in behind when I shifted down. I put it in some box and I like, you know, forgot about it, but recently like I found it and I'm like again using it. It's a sponge, like if you are somebody you know who doesn't like a tool which absorbs a lot of product, then you will not like this because it does like absorb you know, good enough amount of product. But I would suggest this if you're somebody who deals with using a lot of product, like, you know, you kind of tend to go in overboard and then again you get a lot of trouble to blend that out. So if you're somebody like that, then you can definitely give this one a try because it kind of absorbs the product and blends everything really beautifully. I really like this one, such a beautiful. This foundation matches my forehead exactly, but the rest of my face is a little lighter than my forehead, so I'm just going and just tapping whatever is left on the sponge and blending it out. Now make sure you apply everything everywhere in the corners. So next for concealer, I'm using this Flower Beauty concealer. I've been using this for the past few months and I really like it. It does dry down a little bit matte, so like I told you, you do have to hydrate your under eyes really well before you go in with this one, but like, you know, it blends really beautifully, looks really nice as well. Now you can use a sponge or a brush with the concealer. I'm just using a brush because I want a lot of coverage. You can always like, you know, go with a brush and concentrate and spread the product wherever you want it to be, and then you can go in with the brush. This way you kind of like understand where you're placing the concealer as well, but you know, and you get like a lot of coverage with very less product. Just like, you know, stamping and placing and blending it in the way where, so basically I like the highlighted look right here. I don't like to get it till here, but when I use a sponge there might be a tendency I get down till there. So I'm just like, you know, using the brush and just stippling the product, or basically like moving the product in the way I want it to, and next I can just go in with a sponge and just blend that edges and make sure everything is seamless. So now I'm going to go in with the sponge and I'm just going to tap it and blend it out. You can just keep like, you know, tapping in a certain area and things will get blended on its own if you have a really good sponge. Like you can see, right? Only in like that one go, everything got blended very easily. Always remember, you need to blend this area so that the foundation and concealer mix really well. A lot of people don't do this, so you can see the exact difference of where the foundation is ending and the concealer is starting. You can see here that there's like, you can difference, and then here you can not see the difference. Now I'm using this Maybelline, this is a powder foundation and in the shade 310 for under the eyes, because I like I told the K Beauty one is a little like in red, so I like the highlighted effect will go if I use that powder, since it's like a darker shade of powder. So probably maybe I'll go like a shade or two lighter for the under eye like next time I purchase the powder, but for the entire face that kind of seems okay. And then I'm just going to take a brush and I'm going to press everything. Make sure you get into the lines. If you haven't watched how to set your concealer from stopping to crease, you can click right here. So, but for the rest of the face, I'm just going to go in with the Cake Beauty powder and lightly dust it on the entire face. I don't really apply a lot of powder on the rest of the face. Now, next for bronzer, I'm going in with the Sugar Contour the Face Force Palette. Contour the Force Face Palette, correct only. This is in the shade Vivid Victory. I really like this. Is a very nice budget friendly palette. Like if you're somebody who's a beginner, you can definitely, even if you're not a beginner, I think you should definitely invest in this one. It's a really good one. Nice bronzer, nice blush, and highlighter is not so great, but the bronzer and blush are really nice. Taking this brush from La Cara, this is F002. Yeah, if you're somebody who's a beginner and if you're looking for actually affordable brushes, then La Cara has really, really good brushes. I've been really enjoying them. So they have a bundle of brushes for I believe 12 brushes or something, and they're really good quality. I've been using them for over a year and nothing seems to like be bad or anything. All of them are working. This one I really like for the concealer blending. So this is like E006. This one is also like a flat brush. You can press on anything with this. I really like this one for like the precise contour. So yeah, that is one more recommendation if you're looking for one. So anyway, I'm just going in with the bronzer and I'm going to slightly apply and contour my face. I don't know, I'm very hyper today. I didn't have coffee, but I'm very happy. Very nice to be back. I'm happy. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. I'm in that mood. I'm sorry, guys. I know you don't come here for this, but too pigmented or it's not too light. These dogs don't want to stop fighting ever in the night, especially in the night. Oh my god, they start shouting so much. I feel like, you know, right nearby balcony they come and they start shouting so that I should not sleep. They won't like actually bark the entire night, okay? 12:30 or 1 o'clock when I actually want to sleep, that's when they start barking and they don't stop, like non-stop barking at least for half an hour. Now, next for the blush, I'm going to go in with the same blush, I mean same palette. So this is actually a very pigmented blush. Something went into my eye. So you need to be very light-handed. The bronzer is like really properly pigmented, but the blush sometimes can get a little scary. So take it off and dust it and lightly start dabbing. Once you think it's enough, you can brush it off and then you can blend it. Don't go too overboard because of course it's like a very pigmented blush. You can see it looks really beautiful already, and I'm doing like very, very light tapping motions. Again, I went a little overboard here and already it starts looking too much, especially because this color is a little bit deeper for my complexion. But I like it sometimes when I want to go with that very proper mauve pink type of look. But yeah, make sure you go very light-handed. It's gonna fade away by the end of the video, so don't worry. Blush does fade away a lot quicker than all the other products. So today we're going to go in with this pencil from Etude House. This is in the shade gray brown, and I'm just going to brush it and fill the center part. Just that, you know, the tip is a lot fat compared to like my like liking, but you can definitely work with this. Very lightly pigmented, so you can kind of build it really well without getting freaked out and going overboard. Next, I'm going to carve my brow using this LA Girl concealer in the shade Porcelain. You can definitely go back with the concealer which you already used under the eye, but I have an extra one, so I'm using it. I just like to go in with a very light concealer just so that the colors pop a lot well, look really nice. But if you are a beginner, then I would suggest you to go with something which is lighter so that it's a lot easier for you to blend. Now, I'm quite used to blending out things and I try to mix and match even if it doesn't work out. In the end, I kind of, try to make it work somehow. For eyeshadow palette, I think you guys might have guessed it because this is my new favorite. I'm going to go in with Nykaa K, I don't know how to pronounce these yet, but these palettes, really good, affordable, such cheap palette. Three palettes for $9.99. I got them on Hawk Makeup if you want to check them out. So there's actually one more palette I wanted to play with too. So just that, you know, you have options. You can totally work with one palette, but one more palette I'm going to play with is this Lakme Absolute Infinite Eyeshadow Palette. Let's see, you know, after I like dip into the color, then I'll decide if I'm going to use multiple palettes or I'm just going to use one. So first I'm going in with the Birthday Cake Palette and I'm going to just take this hot pink. I'm going to pack that on the inner part of my eye. That looks nice. You can see the pigment, right? It's a very nicely pigmented palette and they blend out well. They don't blend out patchy with this color. There's no name of the color, guys. So I'm just going to go in with that. I'm going to stamp that on the outer edge. So that dark pink or that reddish pink is quite pigmented. So next I'm going in with a very clean brush. This is the Pro Art PE23. I'm just going to buff that edges out. Use the same brush which I used to pack it because the color will become too much, which I don't want. And go in and add later if needed, but when I'm doing it, I should, like, if I go in with too much, then it will become really difficult to blend later. Like to like pull my eyeshadow outwards, make a V so that my eyes look a lot lifted, because you know when you see my face in front, my eye kind of raises this way, right? So I just like take that lower part and start blending it a little upwards. So I take it until like the edge of my brow. Next I'm going in with the Lakme palette and I'm going to take this shade that's called Mysterious, and it's like a very dark deep shade. So I'm just going to add that in the outer corner and blend that, not too much, just right there. Again, I'm going in black with a very clean brush. I'm just going to blend out all the edges. I'm just going in back with this shade and I'm going to blend out those edges so that there is no harsh edge. Now I'm going to go ahead and add this green. This is called Starry Sky. No, this is called Epic Night. Not bad, right? Just going in back with that brush and trying to blend out the edges. I'm going to go in back with that same Mysterious and I'm going to add that on the lower lash line as well. Just going to add it on the outer edge and I'm just going to round it off until the center. Now this shadow does take a minute to blend. It's not really really easy to get a very seamless blend. Even this one blends actually quite good for a drugstore product, but you definitely need a tiny bit of time to blend them. I'm just gonna stop this eye right here. I'll finish the other eye and I'll be right back. Okay, the other eye makeup is on. I even added liner and lashes. So for liner, I've added this Eba Cosmetics Long Stay liquid eyeliner. This, if you want some precision, then you should definitely give this one a try. This brush is so good. It's so thin, so you can get that very thin flick type of liner. No matter how thin you want, you can see how sleek that wing is. Looks really nice. And then for mascara, I added the Lash Paradise, and for lashes I added the pack M75 lashes. Those are like by far my favorite lashes. Look really nice. They're super glam, but they're not heavy. Like you can see, they look really pretty, but when I look down, they don't look very plasticky as well. Before moving on to the highlighter, I just want to say I'm not a very big fan of that green. It says shimmer, but I mean, I'm not getting that, you know, that feel of that shimmer, like, you know, I don't know how to explain that very blinding effect. It's very soft, so this is something you can even use in a crease. It doesn't look bad, but it doesn't just have that power of a metallic shade like I like a metallic shade to have. Like for in case, this is the blue, so you can see that this blue kind of pops really well, but the green is kind of muted down. So first I'm just going to take a setting spray. I always like to spritz my face before I go in with the highlighter, just so that the highlighter will pop a lot more. And for the setting spray, I'm using the Faces Canada Ultimate Pro setting spray. It's a really nice one. One thing I hate about setting spray is that it gets on the hair and all the hair starts getting frizzy. Especially if you have wavy hair, you'll understand the problem. A little bit of wet something, like even if it's like, oh my god, so much disturbance today. So even a little bit of humidity or anything, the hair doesn't stay in place. The spritzer is like that, it's not continuous and it goes tuck tuck and you don't get an even application. Then always go on with your like damp sponge and just lightly dab off that setting spray and just like go over the face so that it kind of gets evenly distributed and doesn't look like a one splash of setting spray. For highlighter, I'm going in with this Nykaa 24 Glam 1 highlighter. Highlighter is done, skin looks beautiful. I'm just going to go ahead and add the Nykaa Glamour Eyes Emerald Wand in my lower lash line. Next, let's move on to lips, and for lips, I'm just going... Oh, I didn't add inner corner highlight. I was thinking that only something looks very incomplete. I didn't add brow bone and inner corner highlight. A Nykaa highlighter. And I'm going to pop that. Inner corner highlight. It like nothing beats it. It just brings all the life needed for a makeup look to get completed. That on the brow bone. Now let's move on to lips, and for lips I'm going in with this Makeup Revolution lipstick. This is in the shade Seclusion. This is from their Blushed Neutral range. Now that lipstick doesn't look as I planned it to be. So I'm just going to go in with this Lakme Absolute lipstick in Mauve Me. I'm just going to add it on the edges. Oh yeah, now I think it's a lot better. So yeah guys, that is the finished look. I hope you enjoyed the video, and if you did, then make sure like, share and subscribe to my channel and ring the notification bell. And thank you so much for watching. I hope you guys are enjoying the series, and I'll see you guys in my next video.